Yeah, hello, welcome back to my channel Smart Codings. Dear students, I hope you are doing well and fine and safe at home. So today I am back again with another topic in the context of programming language, that is Floyd Strangle. So before I start explaining the full concept of programming that is based on Floyd Strangle and the practical demonstrations, I request you to watch this video completely because it's a very important program for board exams and for beginners too. Those who are interested to pursue their career in programming in future, for all of you, it's a very important program. If this video is really useful to you students, kindly do let me know through comment in YouTube comment sections. Subscribe it and click on the bell icon for more updates. So let's get started with the Floyd Strangle. Now, basic definition of Floyd Strangle is: Floyd Strangle is a right-angled triangular array of natural numbers used in a computer science. It is defined by filling the rows of triangle with consecutive numbers starting with 1 in the top left corner. Okay, so this is what is the Floyd Strangle looks like. Starting from the top left, 1, value is 1 here. It prints the series of numbers in a consecutive manner that forms a triangular shape. Okay, and one more thing to keep in mind, dear students, that number of columns in a row depends on the number of row itself. Meaning, I told that number of columns in a row depends on the number of row itself, or number of columns in a row is equal to the number of row itself. Meaning, suppose, for example, let's take this fourth row, this 7, 8, 9, 10. In this fourth row, number of columns is first, second, third, fourth. In fourth row, there are 4 columns. In third row, there are 3 columns. In fifth row, there are 5 columns. Total 5 columns, I mean. In second row, there are 2 columns. There is number of columns depending on the number of rows itself. So to print this Floyd Strangle, let's go back to the favorite editor, that is BlueJ, and write a class over here. Floyd's, let's write here FLYD, Floyd's triangle. Okay, now once this is done, just double click on this to open this. At this point of time, we are just ignoring this documentation part. Just to keep this in mind, this triangle to print starting from 1. So what we need to do is public static. As you know, the every Java program starts with a main method. Public static void main string args, fine. After this, we need to take I comma j, for which will be acting as a control variable for outer and inner loop For that, we need I and J. Fine. And one more, we'll read numRows variable to store the number of rows. How many rows you want to print in a Floyd triangle? Fine. So that number of rows we'll be taking using scanner class. For that, we need to import a scanner class. Use a scanner class. And for to use a scanner class, we need to import the package of scanner class. Import java.util.scanner. Okay. Now let's create a object of scanner class here. Scanner sc equal to new scanner system.in. Why system.in, students? Because we are taking the by default input through keyboard. That's why it's system.in. sc is object of the scanner class. Scanner is a class name. New is a operator to create objects. I hope this part is clear. Now we'll be writing here, students, a message to the user system.out.println. Enter the number of rows. This message will be highlighted in the console or in the screen, output screen. Enter the number of rows. I hope this part is clear. Let's close this. This message is for the user. Okay, now we have to take the input num rows. Okay, we need to take the input in num rows. Then how many rows we need to take input? That will be stored in a variable called num rows. So num rows equal to sc dot next int. Okay. So next int is a non-static method. That's why you can have to access that method using an object. So object.nextint. I hope this part is clear. Now we have to write a outer loop first. I equal to, suppose 1, starting from 1. I less than equal to, we'll be copying this variable because this outer loop will be printing the number of rows in a triangle, and that number of rows depends on this variable num rows, because this num rows value we are taking from the user. So I plus plus. I hope this part is clear. Let's comment it. To print number of rows. To print number of rows. Fine. Now this outer loop is basically to print the number of rows in a triangle. As we have done that already, I equal to 1, I less than equal to num rows, I plus plus. Now inside this we need to print the column also. So let's take a variable here, j equal to 1, starting from 1. As I have said in the triangle over here, that number of columns in a row depends on the number of row itself. In fourth row there are 4 columns, in fifth row there are 5 columns. So column will be depending on the row only. J less than equal to I, that's why. J plus plus. Fine. Inside this loop we'll be printing in the same line system dot out dot print. We're printing let's take a counter variable over here to print the value. Let's take here counter equal to 1. Let's initialize with 1. And let's print this counter over here. Counter. Let's give some space. Fine. Once this is done, so we'll be writing here system dot out for new line. println for new line. Okay. So let's compile this code. Check some error. This is the outer loop. This is inner loop. This is the outer loop. Okay, now let's do the main method, then the class. Now compile it. Counter. So we have to give here int counter. Okay, no syntax error. Let's see the output what is coming here. Right click on this, click on the main method. Suppose 5 rows. So it is printing like this. So as you can see, the Floyd's triangle, the triangular pattern printing the consecutive numbers, natural numbers. So we have to change the logic over here. So let's close this. Let's open the code. And we need to increment the counter variable over here. Counter plus plus. Fine. Compile it. Again run it. Number of rows. Now it's printing the Floyd's triangle. Now how it works. See, there are how many rows? First row, second row, third row, fourth row, and fifth row. In fourth row, there are four columns. In fifth row, there are five columns. That is number of columns in a row depends on the number of rows itself. So let's go back to the code over here. By closing this, let's open this. First, see, I will be demonstrating you how this loop works. The numRows having the value called 5, which are taken through scanner class from the user. The I equal to 1, I less than equal to 5, condition true, will come inside the body of the loop. J equal to 1, J less than equal to I value was 1, 1 less than equal to 1, condition true, it will print counter, the value of counter that is 1, that is, it is printing first 1 here in the first row. Clear? Now, again it will be going down here, it will make the counter variable increment by 1, that is, it become 2 now. Now again it will go here J plus plus 2 less than equal to. So as you know in Java the programming, all the lines are executed serially. So once this, at this point counter plus plus the counter variable becomes the value 2 now. Now it will change the line by executing this statement println, then it will go to the next line and the cursor will set in the next, the second row. Again J plus plus, so J is 2, 2 less than equal to 1 because I was 1, condition false here. So it will not execute. Okay, so it will change this line over here. Once this condition is false over here, so it will change the, it will not go inside the body of the loop, it will go down over here and change the line. Now again I equal to 1, it was there, so I plus plus, that is I become 2 now, 2 less than equal to 5, condition true. Now for 2 less than equal to 5, it will go inside the body over here, inside this for loop body. Now the J loop will execute 2 times, starting from 1 till 2, because I value is 2 now. So 1 less than equal to 2, condition true. So it will print, the value of counter was 2. So it is printing 2 like this in the second row. Again, J plus plus, 2 less than equal to 2, condition true, it will print. So once 2 was printed, counter variable again incremented to 3. So for the second iteration in the J loop, it will again print 3. And like this it continues. So once this condition falls here, it will not go inside this body, this part. It will come down over here for the new line. And again this, and for next iteration for the outer loop to change the number of rows. That is to go to the third iterations for the outer loop. So, and this loop is basically to print number of columns, to print number of columns. I hope this part is clear, students. Basically, it's a concept on nested loop to print a Floyd's triangle. And I've given you the definition of Floyd's triangle here. It's a right angle triangular array of natural numbers used in computer science, where we are filling the rows of the triangle with consecutive numbers starting with 1 in the left top corner. Okay, and the number of columns in rows depends on the number of rows itself. This is how the code works. Go through this code, students. Watch this video. If any doubt, any problem still, do comment me in the YouTube comment sections. Like it, subscribe it for more updates, for more videos based on programmings, which will be very helpful for you. Till the time, take care. Thank you.